Games Done Quick, and this is being put on by Speed Demos Archive, the premier site for speedrun videos and strategies. You can visit us at speeddemosarchive.com. And we are doing this to benefit the Prevent Cancer Foundation, which, as the name implies, is a foundation aimed towards saving lives through cancer prevention and early detection. Their vision is to stop cancer before it starts. They've invested over $130 million in research, education, advocacy, and community outreach programs. And I'm going to go to a commercial now.
What's the next game? Is it Link to the Past?
Zelda 2.
Yeah, we need it now.
I'm putting everything into the shuttle field.
Yeah, might as well.
We need to read it.
Yeah, it's about 1,200 to go still.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Up next is Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link, which... Oh, wow.
There's like 1,200 to go.
And this one is being run by Cypher.
No, this is Feasel.
Feasel, sorry. looking one, two, three.
Yeah, there's like 1,200 to go. Should get it.
1,200 to go on what?
On Zelda 2, Glitch Palace 7.
So we have $1,200 left to go on the donation challenge for this run, which is Glitch Palace 7. If you're interested in seeing that, I suggest you donate now, because we're starting that run, so better get it in. You have until the end of the normal run, which looks to be slated for about an hour and a half. I don't know if that estimate's high or low, but I'd say you probably have a good hour. Still, if you want to get it in, I'd suggest doing it right now. And let's see, what are the prizes we have for this run? So, there are also quite a few prizes we have starting on this block right now. We have the Link and Shadow Link Pearlers, Link versus Gliok Prince, a Master Sword Pearler, a Zelda Block Pearler, Acrylic Triforce, Four Swords Link Figurines, and the Hyrule Shield, all of which we're starting right now. If you donate from now on, and you donate the minimum amount required for each prize, you are in the runnings to draw that at the end of this block. And most of those are around $20 minimum donation, except for the Acrylic Triforce, which is a minimum of $25, and the Hyrule Shield, which is a minimum of $30. And we're bringing those in right now.
Oh my goodness.
All right, so we're showing off these prizes.
All right, so Feasel, if you would hold this Wind Waker for me, if you would demonstrate the proper usage of this Wind Waker.
No, don't do it, Feasel.
I gotta do a one frame.
One frame. Awesome. And if you would take this for me, pass the Wind Waker to, Dragonar, take it for me. Yeah. That is the awesome shield. That actually is heavy. It's really heavy. But Feasel is a big, strong man, and he can... Yeah, it's this. And okay, so that is what, $30?
Yes, the minimum 30. Donation for that is 30.
Okay, and finally, we have this giant Link Pearler. This is $25. This is literally, look, let me compare this to Feasel. It is.
Same size.
It's pretty much the same size. Yeah.
A 1-2 Feasel.
This is a life-size Feasel Pearler, actually. I would donate for that so hard.
I think anyone would.
Yeah, no, for sure.
It is Feasel.
Yeah. So yes, guys, donate. These prizes are awesome. If you're not going to donate for it, I am, and I'll just take them home with me.
Now, these are available through the entire Zelda block?
From now until the end of everything, I believe.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh.
Because these prizes are really, really, really
What
are
the minimum
donations
for each thing?
What's that?
You want a minimum donation for each thing?
Oh,
30, 25, and then we can break up
the wind like this to make some
story. I don't know if I'm allowed to.
I definitely like the second file name, though.
Segment.
Oh, it means this one.
WWPD.
I still try to figure out how the B is.
Bagu.
Oh, it's Bagu.
All right, well, we actually do have some more donations in just now. Josh Arner donates $50. Great work. Put this towards Zelda 2 glitch. And Ben Brownhill donates $15. Hey guys, second donation. Vince Hart again. I can't tell you how great it is to see gamers doing such a fantastic thing as a community. So proud. Put this toward that, I forgot the name. Mentioned often. Die something?
Milkshake sounds good right now.
So what's the name for this?
Oh, I was just refreshing. We got...
Big Russ.
Okay.
It's not Big.
The standings, unfortunately, for the top two, Big Russ is at $614.10, and France Z is at $748.
That's it.
All right, we're gonna check the last donations just to be sure.
No, we cut it off.
Okay.
France Z, it is.
Shout out to losing
there. You go.
All right, I'm ready when you are. Okay. And 3, 2, 1, go. Everybody knows go left out of this palace.
Tompa did not shed a tear now.
Just to make Tompa happy. Now, I don't know if people on stream can see, but while this is dark, people can see the feet of the enemies here. You can see the shadows of the feet. So while he is very good at this game, he's not magic.
Not totally one.
What do you mean?
No,
he's
magic.
Magic.
I don't know what you're talking about. Slander.
Okay, yeah.
Let me just look up there. This is definitely magic.
Okay, I apologize. He's magic. Alright. Avoiding those encounters there is about completing that cave and of just the right window of time.
This one's way harder because you can't see the bats on the ceiling right here, nor can you see them moving down. He has a pretty good idea of where they should be, but he can't tell exactly where they're going to be situated.
Whoa!
The Metroid glitch. That's hard to get.
Normally you don't want to do that because it'll lag the game out, but it's got quite a reaction, so I'm glad.
Yeah, but coming back, you have to hope the bat isn't there in your way.
Sometimes that bat will be... He could be anywhere, really. So we're here for the jump spell. That's what that trophy I picked up will get you.
Seems like we have some time. I'm gonna pound some more donations through here. We got $10 from Anonymous. Loving the run of my favorite Final Fantasy game. Put this towards Zelda 2. And Stephen Hopper says $10 towards whatever the runners want. So, you think Feasel would want Glitch Palace 7?
I think that's what everyone would want.
Okay.
Just fucking correct to open it for anyway.
And Paul Fritzner donates $10. Hi, ingredients from Germany. Please put it to Zelda 2 glitches. Thanks, yes. And keep it up.
And you will get to see the whole game normally, and then I'll just show you the glitch at the end.
Right.
And it'll be pretty fun.
Yep, so we're going through the whole game, which is about an hour and 20 minutes, and at the end of it, if we get enough donations, we will show Glitch Palace 7.
And it'll blow your mind if you haven't seen it. It's pretty great.
Now, this is where it starts to get hard, the way Feasel's playing this game.
Usually you just go through one dark cave and then get a candle, allowing you to actually see in caves, but not Feasel. No. Feasel doesn't roll that way.
Yeah, he wants the hammer.
Oh, and the fairy spell.
That too.
What's interesting is that I was terrible and I did not play this game as a kid, and so I only watched speedruns of this game, and so I was just like, why is this game so dark everywhere?
Yeah.
It's perfectly normal.
And then someone actually got the candle and my mind was blown.
Yeah, I can't play with the candle. This is really... Seeing everything is just too much stimulation. Candle and the cross.
Ross Carr donates $30. Money goes to whatever the announcer wants. Well, I think like everyone else here, I want Glitch Palace 7.
Now, a lot of what Zelda 2 comes down to, in terms of speedruns, is how many encounters you get out of the map. Ideally, you want to try and trigger the encounters to come up and then get back on the road, since you can just walk off the screen like Feasel just did. But the less encounters you get, obviously, the lower time you're going to get.
That was the man, Bagu himself.
That was Bagu. We know Bagu.
He actually says, Bagu is my name. Show my note to Riverman. Riverman does not get a name.
Riverman. Yeah, that's, his first name is River. His last name is Matt.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's exactly what his name is. Now, we'll be picking up our second spell here. As soon as he goes, he's gonna go on a little treasure hunt here.
She lost her mirror, so he's on. Digging under
the table talks to you, by the way.
Now, the current SDA record does not get this spell, which is mind-blowing.
Right, but the actual world record does.
Yes.
Someone can explain the six count at any point here, too. This might be a good time for it.
When enemies can drop items, you know, power-ups, is not random. Basically, every sixth enemy you kill of a particular class of enemies can give you a power-up. You know, there are the small enemies, like the little blue slimes, the bots, and all the other, the bats, the small enemies, they're in the small six count, where every sixth of them you kill will give you either an experience point back or a blue magic refill, which is only one square. The big guys, the hard, the tough enemies, they're in the big six group. They give you a 50-50 shot at either a full magic refill or a larger experience.
200.
And you may notice this is unusual in the Zelda series. You get experience points to power up. That's what everything on the top of the screen is all about.
They wanted to cash in on the Dragon Warrior or Dragon Quest success.
And it turns out it's actually possible to level yourself up well enough without doing any grinding. You know, you can just manipulate the large experience reward you get at the end of every palace. See, what Feasel's doing here is he's skipping a level up here so that he can level up attack as high as possible. Because if you can manipulate your end of palace rewards to be attack level ups, you'll get thousands and thousands of experience points. And so you can get through the whole game without having to go and grind.
He had a very specific level up system that he follows. At certain points in the run, he needs to get a magic level to restore his magic. Anytime you take a magic level, you get a full MP, you get a full magic restore, and there's just points where he actually uses that level up to get it back.
That way he can skip more keys. But we'll see that soon enough. Skip a lot of backtracking.
I'm sure a lot of people, their first time, had a lot of trouble fighting these guys right here.
Now, that is unusual. Those enemies are visible,
yeah,
despite the candle. I don't think it was intentional, but...
There's only orange enemies that are visible.
Yeah. Now, these guys, these are flying fish. They're called Bago Bago, which is a play on the Cheep Cheeps of the Mario series. Only these guys actually throw rocks at you, which is why I call them troll fish.
No.
Oh,
wow. Yeah, I'm kind of low on health, so I may...
This is why you get the life spell.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. This pair of rooms here is just tough. In the dark. And technically, you're under-leveled at this point, because you're not supposed to be here until after you've done the first two palaces. So you're supposed to be a whole lot more powerful, and Feasel's just going here first.
This is Duff Mountain.
Yes.
This is usually a late. Zelda is usually a late game. It's a little more in the middle in this game, but even so.
If you're playing this game casually, this part is tough if you're doing things the slow way.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I'm dead here.
Yeah.
Oh. No.
Well, we got that out of the way.
That
and you get to see your name again.
That little bit. You ready.
Actually, pretty rare to be killed by a bit. What you said?
Oh, no. Wasn't the bit
was
that
the
killed
axe.
Him? It was the bit that knocked him back, and it threw off his rhythm for dealing with the yellow.
Yeah. But that was good that I got that 200 bag there.
That's one of the maze of caves, and it's pretty hard if you don't know where to go. It's easy to get lost.
So I'd like to remind people that we have a running challenge for this game, Glitched Palace 7, and we still have about $700 in change to go before we hit that. So if you'd like to see that at the end of this run, you have about an hour left to donate for that. And not to distract from that, but we also have a file name choice for the next game, Link to the Past. Currently that's standing at $0 for PG-13, $40 for Lunk, $750 for Papo, and $982.47 for F My Hot TAS.
Now this part of the map, the overworld that Feasel was on here, it has two caves right next to each other. That's a reference to the first Zelda game, where level 9 is, you know, on Death Mountain. And this is Death Mountain, so...
Experience Spectacle Rock?
Yes.
In fact, this entire area of the map, you can compare it to the Zelda 1 map. It's pretty much the landscape is made to be Zelda 1 map in miniature.
Yes.
It's kind of interesting. So the implication is that Zelda 2 takes part, takes place in a part of Hyrule that's north of what was in Zelda 1. And I've never seen the other Zelda game.
Hammer gift.
Oh yeah.
Still no candle.
Still no candle.
We need the candle.
I forgot to split.
You know,
the
candle.
Yeah, split people. Come on, man. And you left that pee bag behind. What's going on
What's
here?
Doing with that? Too cool for pee bags.
Yeah, that's what it is.
We have $80 from Martin Hampton. Been loving the whole week and the work you've all been doing. Here's $80 to go on the Zelda 2 dungeon glitch. Keep it up. And we have 20 from Charlie Seelbach. Good work, guys. I always wondered, why does the Dane have a tail?
It's explained in Disc 3.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll see that coming up then. That's the last one we're doing.
That's the explanation.
So stick around for that.
Now this is exactly where level 9 is in Zelda 1. And apparently, Ganon left something behind.
His loss.
We have another 20 from Bruno Lacoste Champagne. What you guys are doing is simply awesome. I'm amazed at the things you do. Thanks for the entertainment. Put this towards Die Hard, obviously.
Good
choice. We're running up top, do we? Yeah.
And Michael Dix donates $40.
Hi, Flip.
Hey, I know that guy.
Great job to all attendees for raising a quarter million. Enjoying Puexel and Spike Vegeta playing FF9 and stoked for all the Nintendo games between now and the end. So proud to be a part of this site. Put this towards whatever Puexel wants.
He was putting it all towards the glitches. Good pass.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like the old sounds
even if he does so. That's right.
Definitely. The old sounds were left, by the way.
We're good at
10,000 complaints on the Die Hard.
Most Zelda 2 enemies are pretty regular in their AI, but those red axe-throwing guys can be random because they can throw two, three, or even four axes in a row, so they can trip you up.
You can't block axes with your shield.
Wow.
Oh, come on, get up.
That's right.
It's like you can cut with woodbone rice, but axes and maces, I think you can't block.
No, you can't.
I don't know if you can with Reflect.
I don't think so. I think Reflect is just for fire.
So we're getting a lot of donations in all of a sudden for Glitch Palace. But we're still not quite there yet. We're still about 300 off. So if you have any, then now would be the time to do it. And we have $25 from Brian Melvin, also known as Finn311. Hey SDA, you guys are doing so much for an incredible cause. Put this donation towards Feasel running Super Dodgeball, either at AGDQ or Summer Games Done Quick.
That's
Magic Pixel.
Oh yeah.
So you can't see, but there are two of the axe throwing guys in this cage. Feasel's able to hit them quickly enough that the hit stun will keep them visible most of the time.
Nice experience.
Feasel is living right on the edge.
Right on the edge.
One pixel life left, the one experience points left to the next level.
These trollfish
might
could
die
be a problem.
Here. We'll see.
Yeah. They can swim through rock.
That, I'll see.
More than much you can do about
yeah.
that.
Yeah, not going to be a deathless one.
Fortunately, there are 3 1-ups that are pretty much on the way.
Yeah, I'm going to pick up another one-up just in case.
Richard Hartley donates $30. Thanks for all you're doing with this marathon. Please put the money towards Player's Choice.
Well, we just assume Zelda 2 until that finishes up.
Oh, we're way ahead of you. Yeah, we already got it. And then Choi Quen Chan donates $20. Keep up the good work. What a good cause. Together we will beat this disease one day. Joel Burassa donating $30. Put half to Glitch Palace 7 for Adventure of Link and the other half to McLean for the OOT file name. Good choice. Ryan Myers donates $50. Zelda Block Hype! Feasel picks what this goes to. And we got it.
So now we're getting our first sword technique here.
Only sword technique.
Yeah, the only one in this route.
Yeah, this one is mandatory for getting through most palaces beyond like the first one. Otherwise, you can't break blocks below you.
It's the legendary bone spot.
Very so overpowered.
Yeah. You need this guy to tell you how to point your sword down.
Right. No, press down.
You break into his home.
I think of that.
You go into his basement, and he rewards you by teaching you how to be stronger.
Rewards you by telling you something that any 2-year-old would know.
So that death I had in the cave actually saved me time here because it refilled my magic, and I would have had to take a detour to the magic refill lady.
Now, the people who refill your magic and life in town, they don't actually just bring it to full, they just set it to, what is it, 3 times your max magic?
It's like 2.5 or 3 times or something like that. It is possible if you are really low on life to, cast life a bunch of times and some other stuff and still not get your magic all the way refilled.
I did that once by accident.
Yeah, it happens sometimes.
But it's also the same thing when you pick up like a red potion. That's I believe 1.5 times your magic.
It's one.
Okay. Same with like the containers.
Yeah, container.
So now Feasel's gotten 3 spells and 1 power-up without going into a single palace yet.
Right. The whole point of this is to get fairy as soon as possible. You want to have a fairy spell before you do any of the palaces.
And it will be a thunder. Because fairy is the most broken spell in the game by a long shot. It's on the exact opposite spectrum of fire.
Oh!
If all else fails, it's fairy.
So there's a misspelling in the game.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Well, it looks to me like we have $3,511 for Glitched Palace 7. So thanks to everyone who donated for that, and I guess we'll be seeing that at the end of this run.
You're supposed to go left to get a key, but...
Feasel's like, keys, who needs them?
Yeah.
Candles for
cash. Yeah, but like you saw right there, fairies can fly straight through doors.
If you don't,
if you don't have a
key.
Yeah.
So that saves a lot of time.
Yeah.
I think the hammer is you plugged in the keyhole.
Now that magic level up came at just the right time so that he could fill up his magic and be able to cast fairy some more.
Yeah, that was intentional. He skipped that tea bag back in the cave because he wanted to make sure he get a magic level up here.
Our own CBX donates $30. Link is saving Hyrule, but Palace 7 needs to be glitched.
Oh, it will be.
Feasel's gonna glitch the crap out of that palace.
Feasel's skipping more level ups so that he will be able to get the maximum experience reward.
Is it 50 or 70
from
the spells?
It's 50.
I was gonna say.
So now you see his next level is at 2,000. When he completes this palace, it will take him all the way up to what his next level is. So instead of getting a few hundred experience, he's going to get 1,500. Now the boss is easy because he went and did all that stuff first and got over level.
You got a key. What are you doing?
Yeah, you're realistically not supposed to be attack level 4 going up against him, right. But yeah.
Is the attack power a linear increase or?
It's a table. It's not even a formula.
Okay.
But yeah, he was able to get through attack level 5 because crystals will bring you to whatever you need for your next level. So
which
he wants to
be...
make sure that whenever he gets a crystal, the next level is some ridiculously high number and he just gets the maximum bonus from it.
An attack is the most expensive level. So, if he levels attack high, then this will just compound. As he gets attack levels in later and later palaces, the experience he gets will just shoot up.
Well, that cave wasn't necessary, but it allowed him to reset the random encounters out here in hopes that he can make it to this point and wait for him to hit him here.
Yeah. Because the swamp is very slow to walk through.
Yeah, you don't want to cover in the swamp.
Somebody
in there.
Right, when you want to hit one of those guys, you can.
Again, you wait right there in case you get a bad encounter that you can get for that one. And here we go, Palace 2. That jar was being elusive.
Yeah. Dodging skills.
He's only the challenge.
Yeah, by the way, we've met almost all of our challenges now. We just met Glitch Palace 7, and we've also met the last Die Hard challenge.
We need another Die Hard challenge tomorrow, I guess.
We probably should, but we do have one challenge left. We have Mike and Vegeta singing in Final Fantasy IX.
Put your money towards that!
Is there a judgmental thing, or does that
is there a glitch to Die Hard?
That's probably a choice. Yes, we definitely have lots of choices, including the one for the very next game. File name. So, still lots to donate for, and we would still definitely appreciate the money. Still trying to reach our next goal of 400k?
Yeah, Feasel was being very cautious around those bots on those platforms, because bots movements are completely random, and they can jump at literally any time. So, if you try to jump up there just as quick as possible, there's a good chance a bot was going to jump at him, hit him, and knock him right into the lava.
Yes, if you've watched my stream, you'd be very familiar with that.
They can double jump, they can triple jump.
They're really unpredictable. They're really top tier enemies. You can't predict at all what they're gonna do.
And at life one, they do a full bar of damage, too.
They're top tier because they're that strong and only need two experience. we're so top, we don't even have to be good.
And there are bosses that are easier to deal with than bots.
Thomas Schick donates $30. Those Zelda prizes are sick. Hope I can get me any of them. Good luck, everyone, and let's keep those donations coming. And yes, we have a ton of prizes that just came up for the Zelda block. We have the Link and Shadow Link Pearlers for $5 minimum. Four Swords Link figurines for the same. Link... no, that's up next. $10 minimum for the Link versus Gliok print. The Master Sword Pearler for $20 minimum. The Zelda Block Pearler for $15. And the Hyrule Shield for $30 minimum that we showed off earlier. And you can see actually on off to the left there the acrylic Triforce for $25 minimum. Whoa. Mind blown.
Should we turn the lights off so you can see the clothes?
Yeah. Feasel plays in the dark.
Yeah, we're playing in the dark anyway.
Feasel doesn't even give you.
For the record, Feasel has the best webcam in the
game.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's
true. Yep. It is fantastic.
Now, the fairy spell wasn't originally supposed to be that broken. In the original Japanese version, you pick up items by hitting them with your sword. So, being in fairy mode, you couldn't fly through the door and pick up the item.
You can fly through other doors, just not item doors.
Right.
You can fly through them, but then it's useless to do so.
Right.
But in addition, the European version had the fairy glitch removed. You can't even fly the doors anymore. So this, the American version actually ends up being the fastest version to run.
Well, the Japanese version is, that's true. But the Japanese version does have the advantage that I don't think the attack costs as much. So you can get a huge amount of attack really early in the game.
That's true.
I think I had attack 8. Out of Palace 2 this way, so.
Thanks to Callan Myers for the $30 donation. I've lost many hours of sleep this week and I couldn't be happier. Put this toward the Glitched Palace. Not sure what it is, but I love watching game breaking glitches.
Oh, it's a game breaking glitch.
Nice.
That was about the best fight.
Feasel, any upcoming donations that you may choose? What do you want to pick?
Oh man, is there only one donation?
Only one challenge yet.
Well,
we do have the choices for file names.
Hot ass.
Hot ass.
Okay.
Felix Cho donates $50. The long-awaited LOZ block is here. Here's to the hopes of preventing any more cancer to take lives of loved ones, as well as chances at the lovely prizes, especially the Triforce and the Shield. Also, we need more Die Hard.
We're gonna get their 2,000 experience from that.
That was over 2,500. Yeah, didn't quite get out. This is the big reason why he doesn't want to get into encounters in here. It takes forever to walk out of those things.
Yeah.
Unless you get a fairy encounter, then it's really good.
We have $20 from William Welch, Yokai here. Congrats on the 250k STA. I'm proud to be part of this community. Also, must has the Link Pearler.
Oh, that's not fair. This is gonna be bad. I'm gonna have to skip something now.
Yeah, you really don't want to get into an encounter in the graveyard at all. Those are just really bad all around.
And he got the encounter on what is supposed to be a safe square, King's Tomb.
Yeah.
It was just really horrible luck where the enemy spawned and how it moved towards him like that.
And thank you to Warren Howarth for the $30 donation. Zelda, put me in for those prizes and throw the rest towards whatever hasn't met its goal yet. You all rock. Hey everyone in the room, can I get a fuzzy pickles?
What is that?
I guess not.
We skipped it with teleport.
It's another bomb thing.
Now, right there he's manipulating the jars out of that statue. Can either be a red iron knuckle or a red jar? I think it's a 50-50 chance, right?
I think this one, it may be like 60-30 or 60-40 or something.
60-30 and 10%, well, we might glitch the game.
10% of the time I do my math wrong.
Sweet. I like that. I like those odds.
And thank you to Joshua Ford for the $30 donation. Hey, love the runs. Great cause. Hoping for some Zelda prizes. And Mark Grimwood donates $30. I couldn't hear how much it was to be put in for the shield, so if I'm short, I'll donate to make up for it. Well, just so happens that you're right on, so... But we'd still appreciate any more donations. Remember, we still have the singing in Final Fantasy IX. And Eric Hayes donates another 30. Been tuning in all week. Amazing runs and a great cause. Thank you all. Put my donation towards the Zelda 2 Glitch Palace.
And that's another thing right there, is that if you're moving at basically Link's top speed, you can actually get an extra block of height when you jump. It works the same with jump spell as well. You'll get a little bit of extra height when you are moving at a relatively fast speed.
However, that little spiny NA, the Mew, happened to be on the square he had to jump off of.
Yeah.
So one of those times he had to break the block. That was just bad luck.
Alright, here you're about to see a move called the Jackhammer, which is taken from the pass.
Yeah. That is performed by jumping and mashing the down button.
Yeah, basically once you get inside one of those enemies' hitboxes, you can mash down, and there's no limit to how fast you can strike when you're mashing down. If you're just swinging your sword normally, there's like a cooldown time, but with the down stab, you can do it as much as you like. Come on, buddy.
Downward stab is definitely overpowered.
It's not as easy. It's not actually that easy to do either, though. Mashing with your right hand on a... Oh, wow! That boss.
Yeah. Oh my god.
He was ready for you.
He wanted you.
Boss are the biggest trolls.
And it's very easy to get hit by the enemy when you're going inside his hitbox, obviously. So doing the jackhammer right takes practice.
All right, if this isn't a pee bag, I'm going to need to go back. It isn't. All right.
That was a 50-50 shot.
I'm a little low on experience because I had to do some adjusting of the route to make up for some extra guys I had to kill. But my experience needs to be 249 folks by the time I leave this room. It's not getting any higher by getting in that guy.
Yeah, a few of us steal experience. We're gonna get
this. Oops.
These little heads here are actually unique in that they don't drop any items at all. You can kill as many as you want, you'll always get experience.
There we go.
Show these off, I totally forgot about these.
We have here some more prizes for the Zelda book.
Yeah.
Yep, and this is a $5 minimum donation.
We have a Link and a Dark Link Hurler. And that is a
$5
buy-in. So, we have... So, the pile of Zelda prizes grows ever larger.
Yeah.
We have... a ton of them, so $30 and you will be entering the drawing for all of them.
That's correct. Yep.
It's funny to see a Pearler at the standing thrust because that's the slowest sword attack in the game. That Feasel will actually be using the least in the run.
But your Pearlers take a lot of time to make, so it's almost the easiest one to have Link pose for.
The trick to dealing with this boss that I think Feasel was the one who discovered. If everything goes right,
get under.
Come on, go left, go left.
Yes!
Yeah.
Oh, come on. No.
Oh, wow. Oh, oh wow. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
And walk off to the left.
To go all the way under.
Oh, no! He almost had it there.
Well, I get a second chance to do it.
For whatever reason, if he's all the way on the left side of the screen, he can just downstab him to death.
Normally, once he'll get under you, he'll die very quickly. In fact, the life bar will get confused and not even take all the life off.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, perfectly skipped all.
So now he's going to get 4,200 experience from this.
Yeah, he had to have more than 800 though, because that was the cost of a life level. So he had to have minimum 500 experience going into that one.
We have $50 from Lloyd Monte Carlo. It says, great marathon this year as always. AGDQ is always awesome. Put this toward the Glitch Palace 7. Thanks. P.S. Feasel, I hope you get the red jar drop in Palace 6 for the Attack 7 against Thunderlips. Good luck.
No, this time around, he's not taking an attack level. He's just leveling everything else really, really quickly.
Is that Simple Dude?
I don't know. Somebody who knows their stuff, though.
Yeah. Simple Dude is a runner who's a real threat to us. To take the record someday.
Alright. So right here I'm trying to reset the small six count. And I just saw the drop is there, so I want to kill one more. Oh, that was two more. Alright. So now I'm one ahead. I need to skip one enemy that I would normally kill. Because I'm trying to get a drop to happen at a certain time so that I can cast Fairy in a place that will save a few seconds.
See, when he went on that square there, it was a nice town with an old woman. So it was really bad luck to get in count.
Yeah, yeah. It happens.
Well, that town down there is, well, unimportant. We don't go there. There's only one thing in that town, and it's only visited for 100%, and when you get there, it's never used.
What is it?
The fire spell. There's a woman who lives about 10 yards from a fountain. She's thirsty, and she's too lazy to go get her own water. If you get her water, she rewards you with a spell that's useless.
No, it has a use if you actually want to kill everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There are enemies in the US version that you can only kill with the fire spell, but they're not actually that important to kill. It's easier just to down thrust and hop over them.
Yeah.
I think we'll see that coming up in an encounter. Casting Fairy there lets him skip the animation of holding the item up.
Small time saver. It barely saves any if you take the time take into consideration how much time it actually takes to go into the menu. But it is a small time saver nonetheless. At this point, any time savers are good. Due to how much competition there is for this record right now.
These are enemies you don't deal with fire, right?
Yeah. Right. Those are the two enemies.
Yeah.
Types.
Yeah. The only two.
Now this island is actually a little strange in the sense that if you try to take the shortest path to the palace, you're gonna go through a lot of battle scenes. So the trick here is just to go take the longest route all the way in.
We have a $50 donation here. DC Kitty here. I've never been more proud of the geek community. We are awesome. This is to be put in the running for more awesome Zelda swag. And Randy Shiflin donates $30. Hi guys, put this towards Zelda 2 Glitch Palace. Roy Van de Sand donates $30. Hi guys, second donation from me. I want to thank you for the hours of entertainment you brought me. Also, I want them Zelda goodies. So take my money. Greetings from the Netherlands. And we have another 30 from McGack. Here's to reaching 300k and beyond. It's been fun so far, and I'm looking forward to the rest. And Ian Sampson donates $20. Thanks for the great show for a great cause. My mom is a cancer survivor, and if only no one had to go through what she did. Here's to the Glitch Palace. And $25 from AlecK47. I want that Triforce. We have $5 from Craig Sims. This is another donation dedicated to my friend CB32, who is currently in an intense war with nasal cancer. Also, a big 502 crew shout out to Gaussox. See you in 2015. Put this towards Trihex and Carl as cutest couple.
I don't know what the 502 crew is yet.
And And Sten Larson donates $30. I always enjoy your Zelda 2 runs, Feasel. Put this towards the glitch.
Alright. That was the place where I wanted to get that drop, and that allows me to have just enough magic to cast Fairy one more time. But I may not do it, because there's something else I can do that people will like better.
Ceiling skip.
And Chris Reynolds donates another $30. Rumi here. This is my first marathon, and I love it. All the runs have been amazing, and thank you to the runners and crew for making the best donation marathon gaming event ever. It's dangerous to speedrun alone. Take this. Let Feasel decide. And did you say you're gonna go for F my hot TAS?
Sure.
Put it for just Feasel as you discuss.
Oh yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Now here's a kid you have to rescue.
Kill.
We met a few rules in it. It's fine. We'll bring it back to the parents. It'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
Now remember what I said, in the Japanese version, you have to pick up items by stabbing them.
Yeah.
And that child is an item, therefore.
Yeah. Though, in the Japanese version, that sprite actually has some ropes on it, so
yes.
It's like tied down, so I think that's how they try to explain it away. So but you still stab the kid.
You not only stab the kid, you're stabbing the rope to try and get them off it.
So they said.
We just hope Link is good enough aim.
We'll find him that way.
Now, this whole area was meant to make you do a bunch of backtracking. You were supposed to save the child first, then come this way to get the reflect spell, then go to Palace 4 and do everything.
Or but, maybe go into Palace 4 and discover that you can't actually beat it because you don't have the reflect.
Right, yeah. Yeah. Get to the boss and have to die because you're stuck.
Oh, wow.
Have to game over because you're stuck, really.
By the way, I don't think we've had a roll call yet for this run. Can we get at least the people on the couch? Well, everyone in the front.
Well, I'm Prez J. Polk on SDA, Neil Stevens. Hi.
I'm Dragon Dark.
I don't know if you've seen him, but I'm Kenneron 666.
And this punk right here is Feasel.
Hello. Speedy Feasy himself.
Now known as Bayou Feasel. The Fees.
Yeah, the Fees is the way to go.
Feasy Feasy.
He goes by many names, but there's only one feasel.
You can get the upward thrust in this town, but we don't care about that.
It has like one use in the entire game, and we know how to get around that.
Oh, yes.
We have another 30 from Steven Kubinski. Donated again to get in for those 6 Zelda prizes. And yes, you donated enough to get into the running for all of those, but I'd like to remind everyone we also have the grand prizes still up, and it's a $30 minimum to be in the running for the Wii U, and $40 minimum for the Gunblade.
The descriptions you get about the people teaching spells are weird. This magic will strengthen a shield. You might think that's the shield spell, but...
No.
Nope.
Well, hey, the fairy spell is...
This magic word will give you power. Well, it does.
And then later, there's the spell, which is, you know, remember the magic word.
that bubble could have just ruined his day.
Bubbles and birds.
Bubbles do, like, no damage, but they always appear, like, right where you don't want them to.
Hits do lots of damage.
Yes, hits do incredible damage. They're like top tier.
What's cool is they put those air bubbles right next to a heart container you're supposed to get near the very start of the game. And I think that's a no small part of how this got such a reputation of being such an annoying game, because those air bubbles are so hard to deal with because they're so random.
Now I can walk on water.
Yeah, the boots he picked up are what are allowing him to do that, but you can't walk on just any water. It's only specific water. And you can't tell the difference between what's good water and what's not.
I mean,
you just have to kind of know.
Just have to look. Is it muddy? If bad, then it's dangerous.
Feasel can usually walk on water, but in the game, he needs the boots for it.
Yeah, in the game, they can do things he normally, he can do just fine outside of it.
We have $5 from Danielle Winters. Just wanted to say you guys are doing an awesome job. My mother is a cancer survivor, and while I know $5 is not much, I know every bit helps. And yes, it certainly does. We appreciate donations in any amount, and all of the money goes directly to PCF.
Now again, right back there, he killed an enemy and then immediately cast Fairy to use the rest of his magic, and then got the level up just as soon as he finished casting it. If he hadn't gotten that cast off before he got the level, he would have been way off on magic power.
Yeah, I probably would have had to take him to death there, or leave the palace and come back or something. Of course, that door, you were supposed to have the upward thrust to have, so you could get that key that was above them.
But you can actually get it without upward thrust by glitching into the ceiling.
Sometimes I do that when I have upward thrust, just out of spite.
Alright, I need serious time here, so...
Okay.
Yeah. That's a lot of work holding that key.
If you reach that boss without the spell, you're gonna lose out and you can't do anything. Because the spell allowed him to bounce the magic back.
The shots can be blocked by your normal shield, but you can't reflect.
Yeah, and that's the only way to damage that boss.
You can't hurt him with the fire spell, obviously. You can't hurt him with your sword. You can't hurt him with anything but his own magic.
They don't tell you this. At all.
We have $50 from Ryan Henderson. Great job, guys. Adventure of Link is my all-time favorite game, so I had to donate. The runner can choose where this goes. Now, Feasel, are you sure you want to go with your file name choice again?
What about the cutest couple? Is that still open?
You and us, or just yourself?
How about us?
Hey, buddy. Hey, I mean, if you ask us, we'll tell you that you are the cutest couple. I don't know if you need money, though.
I don't know. I think Feasel is the cutest couple here.
I'm not going to run through all of the choices for that, because there are way too many, but the top two for cutest couple currently are Mike Vegeta and Spike Uyama, and Carl Sagan and Trihex. So...
Are we a dram in that list?
You are.
Yes.
I think it's just you.
All right, I like that one.
We actually don't have Just Feasel. Oh, we do, I'm sorry.
Yes.
Just Feasel has $31, but Dram and Feasel still has zero, so if you want to go for that, too.
Oh, okay. How about Dram and Feasel?
Okay. We have our first donation for Dram and Feasel, putting it in third place.
Wow, immediately shoots up.
We'll have a big crown to go with all this for the king and queen. We have no idea who they're going to be.
They get to fight over who gets the queen.
If Just Feasel wins, he gets both crowns. I don't know how that's going to work, but we'll give him both.
We'll make it work.
We'll find a crown, too. We'll make it a double crown.
One of those Burger King crowns?
We get two and three, we'll do each
one. A double chicken crown.
We have lots of luck, thanks.
At this point, Feasel's already gotten so many experience levels. Like, he doesn't even care about point bags anymore.
Well, this particular palace, I don't need any experience at all. I'm just killing guys to keep the six count in the right place.
We have $25 from Steven Rigoza, who says, I love Zelda 2. Put this towards Dante in DMC3. And by the way...
Yeah, he picked up a key. That wasn't from the boss.
That's as far out of the way as I'll go for a key. That's the slowest key game.
But
he made
by
that
the way,
look
the,
easy. It's actually kind of annoying to kill those guys with the jump spot.
Especially that up that close and that small amount of space. It's, the jump spell makes everything harder to fight.
Alright, let's see if I can get it in this time. We have that Virgil and Dante choice for Devil May Cry 3, which is after the Zelda block. And I actually remember several days ago, Poxnor shot Virgil up quite a bit, so that's still in first place. Well, I was actually there, and I read that donation, so I'm sure it was. And Virgil is at $1,200, and Dante is at $1,000. I'm a fan of Dante myself, so please donate for that if you can. Possibly. I could be wrong.
The monster AI there is very, you know, regular and controlling when you're moving, how you're moving, really manipulates where the monsters will go. So that's how he was able to avoid taking a hit there in that confined area.
Those orange bridge robes are some of the most troll enemy in the game.
But they are worth a lot. They're worth 200, which I think is the most lucrative enemy.
If you can kill
them. If you can kill them, it's really hard to kill them.
And this wall here, most people don't even realize you can go through that.
Yeah.
If you're first time playing, you have no way of knowing you can do that. You just walk up, you see a wall, well, dead end, turn around.
Yeah, in the Japanese version, that blue knight is actually Horsehead. Horsehead makes his reappearance there. And so you fight him, and then there's a wall immediately after him.
that was awesome for our version.
Yeah.
I'd love to see Horsehead somewhere else.
Yeah, in the Japanese version, the Horsehead also has a sound that he makes, sort of a horse whinny that sounds kind of crazy.
Barba makes that sound, too.
Yeah, it's more like a shriek.
Yeah, it's kind of a
I think it's meant to be a roar, but, you know, with the technology.
Japanese version of the boss differences.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the original helmet head is easier in Palace 2, and then the full-up helmet head is what you get in Palace 5. And Barbara looks completely different and is taller.
Now, the Fonzie plot in the last palace was serious time jokingly. This actually is serious time.
One more, come on.
Yes.
Killing that guy with the minimal levels was a MagFest challenge a couple of years ago.
Yeah, that must be crazy.
No, funny thing, that guy is called Boss Guma. We don't actually see the regular Guma enemy in this route. Feasel has completely avoided them all by avoiding so many keys. But that guy is supposed to be the big version of the little red guy who throws hammers.
Oh, I didn't know that. Wow, I just learned something.
Blown his mind.
Yeah, that boss can only be damaged from the side. So you can't just do any downstabbing or anything. And he waited right there because if you happen to get a level up on the same frame that you exit a screen, you'll crash the game.
Yeah, there wasn't much of a chance of that, but I just wasn't going to take any chance at all.
We've seen him do it by accident.
Twice in practice. Since I've been here twice, I saw like this.
Wow. I did it like 2 days ago. They fixed it in the U.S. Virtual Console, but they did not fix it in the Japanese Virtual Console. I learned that the hard way.
That's pretty rough.
Yeah, it kind of is. Fortunately, these things don't do much damage.
He tried to skip the first encounter of these by getting an enemy to run into him on that, but
I didn't get a pattern for it. It just didn't happen.
Yeah, that one's really hard to manipulate away.
This is Nintendo's answer to Bullet Hell right here.
You also can't block any of those.
I think you can, it's just mostly they come from above and that makes it hard to.
No, I think you need reflect for it.
Yeah, I've never been able to do it. Look, be careful.
Alright, I'm doing that.
Setting the encounter right there.
Just reset the encounter so I can do that.
And he triggered he triggered those encounters to appear when he was on the swamp. Because the kind of tile you're on determines how far away the enemies will spawn from you. In the forest, they will be very close together. In like the grassland or the swamp, they'll be further away from you. So it gives you more time to dodge them.
Yeah, there's all kinds of strategies for manipulating the overworld encounters. None of them are foolproof. It's always some chance that it'll go wrong, but you try to kind of, you know, maximize your odds.
Now, here you probably can't see it, but there is a red. He has kind of like a mace that you. It's unblockable. We don't fight those.
Nope.
They're harder than your orange counterparts with the spears, and they give less experience.
That's a bad deal all around. Alright, I'm going to pick up the spell called Spell, and you don't technically need it, but, and I don't get it anymore when I'm doing actual, you know, RTA attempts, but Marathon, I think it's probably worth getting.
It makes the approach to Palace 7 much easier.
Yes.
Because it turns most enemies into bots, the little blue slimes.
That doesn't sound like a good trade to me, honestly, now that I think about it. Yeah.
Is the magic word bees?
The magic word is pro tier.
I've always assumed it's knee. I'm weird.
So we had a local donation for Dram and Feasel, which would have tied it for first place with Mike Vegeta and Spike Uyama, but those have been relegated to third place now because we had several other donations for Siglemic and Cosmo putting it at second place with 125, and just Feasel for $161.
Good job, Feasel.
It is possible in this town to get the magic key, which will open all doors forever, but eh.
We have the fairy spell. We don't need no stinking keys.
I mean, who wants to walk all the way to the end of town, really?
I know, right? There's not even an exit on that side of town.
That's true, that's the only town you can't walk all the way through, isn't it?
Probably would be almost worth it if you could walk all the way through.
Yeah, it would be that. Well, almost.
It'd cost a lot less time, so it might actually be worth it since you wouldn't have to worry about magic fairy anymore.
It's true. That encounter is probably the hardest one to skip coming out of that cave there.
Yeah. Because it's all forms.
I very rarely get a skip. There we go. Oh, that's not bad.
Diesel's actually getting a heart container here because it's pretty much on the way.
And if I had done it right, it would have been a way of avoiding encounters. If I had gotten to this square, it would have reset the encounter. So it actually, picking up that heart container saves time, actually. Oh!
Oh.
What am I doing?
Oh, wow.
Pretty long.
That's
pretty unusual.
That guy had some aim. Oh, hey, I'm not
there's
all
two things you
actually
use to
flute
for
in
this game, right?
Yeah, that's the only thing. Oh no, you need it to get across the river.
Yeah, you avoid the river monster. You drive the river monster away.
Yeah, that was the first thing on opening this spell. Second thing. That's the only two things, right?
Yeah, the flute's basically more like key.
Yeah. But it was two doors.
Yeah. It was originally the river demon in the Japanese version, but Nintendo of America wanted that changed.
Guy is stronger than I remember.
Yeah, kind of demons. Kids might think it's okay to be a demon.
Come on. I was hoping for it. It's possible when you fall through there to land on the ceiling so you can skip that door. I was rooting for it there.
It's killing these guys because, yeah, they're just like bots.
They're pretty bad. You know what? I kind of want this. Alright.
First thing with Medusa has to give way against it.
Yeah.
From Justice of Elite.
Feasel, by not getting keys, skips a room similar to that I think is one of the very hardest rooms in the game because it's so easy. It's the last key in Palace 4. Where you can just get knocked in so easily by those dragon heads.
Oh, there's more than one of those rooms, too. One of them has a blue iron knuckle in it.
Alright, we have another $30 from Joseph Isepi. Awesome work, guys. My mother had kidney cancer, then bladder cancer, and after 8 years of fighting it, she's finally cancer-free. What you guys are doing is a great thing. And Benjamin Pacode donates $30. Those prizes are awesome. Put this towards the Zelda 2 glitch. And Nick Morrissey donates $30. Fantastic stuff to win. Donating for my cousin who died when he was three, and he was who died when I was three and he was four from neuroblastoma, and my uncle who died a few years ago from esophageal cancer.
Because I had to cast life there, I'm a little low on magic, so I'm gonna just find that guy for a potion.
And as we explained earlier, every sixth small enemy you kill will give an item drop, and most of the time that drop will be a blue jar. If you'd gotten unlucky there, that could have been a 50-point experience bag. Rebinac makes a return here. There.
Something else we haven't mentioned is that when it comes to magic and life, you look at the bars, each full bar represents 16. And all your spells, I mean, you see high numbers for that, you'd think, well, wait, you don't have that anywhere near that many bars. No, it's 16 per bar. Your max is 128 with everything.
And you have to get all the magic containers in order to get the final spell, which you need to kill the second to last boss.
He's a real final boss, who are we kidding?
Well, you know the trick. It is possible to jump on top of this guy and downstab, but it's incredibly risky.
Jackhammer him.
Yeah.
That was still a good fight.
Yeah, that was quick. That was quick. Right. Recycle.
No, that was the only key in this palace, by the way. This key has no palaces. This palace has absolutely no keys. They intend for you to have the magic key going through here.
And this is the final leveling Feasel will have.
It's actually a new leveling method too, because what Feasel used to use was a 777 to take an extra attack level at the end, but that's been kind of changed up.
Yeah, that was something ProJN came up with. So I came up with mostly the leveling route that you see here, and then ProJN came up with two pretty useful improvements on it that I've then incorporated back into it.
ProJN being the current record holder.
Who rose to power very quickly. Like, he was playing around with the game, you know, maybe about 6 months ago, and he just got super good at the game real fast. So you should definitely watch him stream, pro_JN.
Now, what are those two improvements you mentioned?
So one was the 6-7-8, so that you don't have to rely on statue luck in that, and the other is moving the drop. Moving the drop in Palace 2 so that it actually happens just before Palace 3, and you don't have to rely on the statue potion at the beginning of Palace 3. Or at least it gives you one free shot at it that you don't have to stop for. That's going to be a fairy.
Normally you would be able to see that ghost Feasel killed there in the town, but he skipped the cross, so... And that's the only time it actually matters, because every other time you would want to use the cross, Feasel wouldn't be able to see them anyway because it would be dark, because he doesn't have the camera.
Alright, I'm going to do an encounter skip here, just trying to get a wandering monster on top of this square.
Now, this is called Death Valley. Yeah. For a reason.
Yeah.
There was a red jar there. It doesn't always appear. Fortunately, it appeared this time.
Now, he's going to be skipping three specific encounters.
Oh, fairy? Come on.
Oh, no.
It's gonna be the. Oh, do that.
There's invisible walls on the side, too. For no reason.
That's not it. I didn't get it.
So now use a spell to turn all of the enemies in here into bots so you can get out easily.
I didn't get it.
Because they're invisible flying enemies.
You got two more to get through.
That was the drop. I'm waiting for a blue potion from one of these guys. I think it'll be the next one.
Ooh. Yeah, skipping these encounters is actually a lot more difficult than it looks.
But the encounter, those fixed encounters on the road are long and difficult. So it's worth it to go through all that effort to try to get past them.
Oh, I don't want to do it.
These are always filled with those red eyes you've seen, but that kind of open and close them.
I might get completely destroyed. Yeah, I'm low on magic, and so
yeah,
I have to take it risky.
You can't see them at all.
Oh, I knew he'd do that to me. Ooh, I knew it. He's been doing that in practice runs.
Oh, yeah.
There's that.
I may take a death here.
No.
There's a blue guy there throwing maces, which can't be blocked with the shield.
Well, this gets me into the palace, but I'm still in a life crisis, so I may get killed by this red guy coming up.
There's another blue guy throwing maces.
You cannot block those.
And that's one of the red guys with the unblockable mace.
And we're in Palace 7. With about 8 magic and 1 life.
You can do it, Feasel.
Yeah. So right here I might tank it, but we'll see.
Fortunately, if you game over in the Great Palace, you get to continue in the Great Palace, so. Nintendo was kind.
Hopefully it won't come to that.
Yeah, hopefully.
I think I've got two more deaths that I can do, yeah.
Oh, good. Oh, yeah. You got this.
That's why you picked up those extra lives, because it allows them to... gives them a few extra shots at this stuff. And, well, marathon luck.
Well, yeah. I died in a bunch of places that I don't usually do, so that's kind of weird.
I'm always positive that Nintendo meant for the jumping fish to be on this screen.
Yep.
Because there's nothing here, right?
Yeah. And it's the bridge like they always have, but thank you, Nintendo.
Trying to lull you into false sense of security there.
Oh, wow. Good.
Getting past two of those guys without getting hit is really good.
Yeah. I'm blowing
out.
Yeah. No good. No. We still have one more life to go.
Here's another place where the jackhammer is useful. Just getting lots of hits on those guys quickly.
Those things take a lot of hits.
Especially at attack 6.
Alright, well that's a good pattern right there.
Oh yeah. That guy can jump right into you.
Now remember when we said bots were like pro tier? Yeah, they get stronger in here.
They take more hits.
More hits and they get more damage.
He's getting past the tough enemy.
The tough enemy is no
dragon
problem.
It's a red jar right here.
I'm just gonna get these guys out of the way. I don't even know why I need it. I guess I'm just... it's a safety net.
He's going to make sure he's topped off. Because this room is actually relatively difficult. He goes up here for a reason. You'll see it in just a moment.
Skipping this guy.
Arguably the hardest regular enemy in the game.
Ironically, I've actually found a way to cheese this guy with upstab, but we don't have upstab.
Yeah. Notice how those guys spit fire instead of rocks. Everything gets an upgrade in Palace 7.
Yeah, there's snakes that spit fire. Yeah, there's snakes that spit fire everywhere. But that's the only one along this route, I think.
Skulls get bigger.
Oh!
Yeah.
There's curtains and multiple screws.
The jumping Bonefish also spit fire, but we don't see any when you go. This is the right way. This is the way you're intended to go in Palace 7. And we don't see any, fortunately.
There's an alternative way to go that involves an out-of-bounds glitch that is just barely faster in theory, but in practice not necessarily.
You pick up the safety.
Yeah,
safety fairy.
It's not really needed. I don't know why.
There's also a one-up on the other way, but it takes forever to get. When you're pro tier, you don't need it.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
I wasn't expecting that to work.
How did that even work?
That was just...
Physics.
Don't
push it. The fireball hits the ground. It's going to the right.
This is why we donate for just Feasel.
It's our fearless Feasel.
Now, that guy is actually very handy to upstab, but...
Yeah, that's like the primary use of upstab in any percent
of time. So I can probably do this without going for the potion.
Oh, that's gutsy.
Well, I mean, it'll be two hits to kill me, regardless of whether I have full health.
It doesn't matter at all. Now, you need the Thunder Spell to hit this guy in order to make him vulnerable.
So you can get here and be stuck. If you don't have that spell.
It happens sometimes. I'm talking to my stream chat. I don't get thunder.
I've seen people get here and forget the thunder spell.
Because you have no other reason to go to that town.
Oh, that's a bad place.
Now, Thunderbird takes 16 hits to kill it at 6 attack.
I think that's about right.
It's around there.
It's 15 or 16.
Thunderbird was... This is who that earlier donation was referring to. Thunderlips.
Yeah. There's no Thunderbird, but it's just fire.
That's a good
point.
Oh! I almost had him. One more hit.
Use Thunder against him.
Yes.
I've actually walked into the room and accidentally used Thunder like the moment I walked in. It's like, uh-oh.
Yeah, I did that too.
Hopefully it wasn't your last life. It is possible to manipulate him into a nice pattern where he'll always swoop down where you can hit him. Like we're seeing right here. When he's moving back and forth, it spreads out the fireball, so it's easier to dodge them.
You also cannot down or upstab this guy. It has to be standard sword thrusts.
So sometimes you'll see people cast jump to try to get more hits, but obviously at Magic 7, you don't have enough.
He goes ballistic like this when he gets down to half that.
There it is.
Nice. Wow. Oh, final boss down, we're done.
Yeah. This guy is tough, but...
There's some stuff you can do. Like, I'll be turning around and standing up in order to manipulate him into approaching instead of hanging back. But for the most part, if you just stand in the corner and duck stab, it works.
And then when this guy dies, it's time?
Yes.
Yeah, it's like a slightly after it, whatever. I'll let you know.
Funny thing is... The same strat of standing in the corner and thrusting works for the final boss of Zelda 1 and Zelda 2.
he is
Super Mario
full of vinegar today.
Yeah.
Wow. There we go. And stop.
Time.
1:12:05.
All right. Let this scene play out, and then I'll go and show the glitch.
You want to hold the tripod above your head, please?
So yeah, there you go.
So <Da-da-da-da.
laughs> Do we want to know what he's wishing for, though?
We'll guarantee that one can wake up sleeping princesses.
Milkshake.
Well, it's you, princess.
Alright. Now I'm going to reset it and we'll show off this glitch Palace 7 here.
When I first heard about this, I was wondering if you were going to be playing on Deserac Zelda 2 card.
Oh yeah, that's the whole game will be glitched.
You just glitched everything. Frame feasel.
No, actually it saves time because you'll get a better monster spawn like that if you go right. If you're planning on going this direction, this is the best way to go. If you go left, you'll get a monster right in your way.
So this is a new game plus run, right?
Right. Now, well,
new game minus.
New game minus. Yeah, so I just have a save file I'm using that has, basically all you need to do this glitch is the jump spell, the fairy spell, the raft so you can get out of here, and the glove so you can break blocks, and that's all you really need to beat the game if you do this glitch. So you can actually beat the game in about 20 minutes.
Gonna be good. I've never gotten to see this live before, so this is gonna be fun.
This town over here, it's something special.
Should I try to do this? Yeah, well, nah. I'll just do this normally.
Let's get fairy ready.
Yeah. I'll skip the next one.
Oh, that's perfect.
Just walked right into you there.
I think even the monsters are excited to see this.
Yeah.
Nope. This is the healer lady.
Hello. That one box makes me good. Supposed to be able to do that. Welcome to Glitch Town.
Well,
it's like that.
It's better. Here before.
See, legit.
They're sick.
Alright, and that right there gave me scroll lock, which means that all the rest of these levels are going to be.
Brown is chasing you.
Yeah.
Pits do actually exist right here.
Yeah.
You have to be able to jump.
The pits are there, yeah. I just have to know where they are.
Because the world sure doesn't know where they are right now.
Alright, cool. What?
It gets better.
Yeah, that's just the tip of the iceberg. These encounters are nice and easy, you just walk off the screen.
Bye.
No. The adventures of Long Warps.
Oops.
Oh, Pal 7.
This run has officially become error.
So error's fault. Bagu didn't do enough to stop it.
And here we have barrier skip right here. No barrier.
Yeah, you normally can't get into Palace 7 unless you've done all 6 palaces.
Well, we say no to that.
Yeah.
So some semblance of real floors here. Oh, well, there goes that idea. Sprites in the lava, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be fish. They're trying.
They need to get out. This is a normal day for feasel.
Yeah, this looks perfect. This looks perfectly normal for this place.
I'm guessing it was casting that figured this out and made a couple questions and then checked.
Questions in the
chat. Figuring this out, yeah. Jazzing to figure
Oh yeah, this has been known for a long time. The reason why this wasn't ever used is because you still need to get the thunder spell, because no one knew of a way of passing Thunderbird until Solar Flare discovered it recently. And so this that skip that I did there has been known for like almost 10 years, I think. But the key thing that was still required was getting all the magic containers, getting the thunder spell, because you need all that to fight Thunderbird. But now we can do the Thunderbird skip, which I will do coming up. Alright, I'll probably do this potion just so I don't have to.
Good jar luck there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but see, the whole game is excited about this glitch.
Won't even let him scroll to the left anymore.
Why did I say that? Go away. Go get out of here. Oh, I can't even heal me. Oh, I'm alive. Oh. Come on. Come here.
He is...
He's trolling hard today.
He's a champion.
That guy money or something.
He is not happy about this glitch.
With help.
Wow, he really is after me.
He is really not happy about this right now.
It's like, he's coming right.
I was like, you broke the game. What are you doing?
What have you done to my home?
Yeah.
Keep on walking into the tables.
It's hard to tell, but he's going a different way to the palace than he did before.
Well, it's mostly the same, but I'm taking a few little shortcuts.
No.
Okay, that's alright. I needed to kill myself anyway to get my magic back before I do this next trick, so if not there, I would have done it.
And because we wanted to see the milkshake again.
Yeah, that's true.
Milkshake, I mean, they're awesome.
So, will anything cause you to lose the scroll lock, or...?
Once you get into here, no. Like, this is the one place in the game where if you die and, or if you game over and continue, you'll actually keep scroll lock.
Okay.
This palace. Although it is possible for me to get stuck in this palace and have to, like, up A to get out of it.
If you pause and hold up and press A on the second controller, it's like an instant game over.
Yeah, we don't mess with the boss. Those guys.
No.
Well, Link's just kind of taking a look. Well, there's a room here. I don't want
this. Nice try. Oh, that's better. That's better. Alright, this is Thunderbird Skip. You can do this even without the whole scroll lock thing. You can do this just normally. Right there it is.
Nice.
And then again here.
Dancing on the ceiling.
Dancing on the ceiling.
Only two pitfalls in the ceiling.
And we just bypassed Thunderbird entirely.
Nice.
I don't think that's what he's supposed to be.
Why, hello, Dark myself.
It's camouflaging. One thing about this boss is that no matter your attack level, he always takes one bar of damage for it.
Same thing with your life level, he'll always do one bar of damage.
I think he always takes 9 hits to kill regardless of your attack level.
All he needed to do this...
It's the same.
...were the raft, the handy glove, all the things you can get on the western continent at the start of the game.
The
game's still confused.
you beat half the game, you get half the game. Oh wait, how is it whole again? What?
Yeah.
It's the power of the Triforce.
Yeah. You guys should play Zelda 2. Everyone pick up this game. Start playing
it. It is a good game.
It is.
I think it's quite underrated.
Yes.
Definitely.
We have Cypher here?
Yeah.
That's all I got.
Alright, well that was it for Zelda 2. Up next is A Link to the Past, but right now we're going to go to a commercial.
12.
I'm trying to get it.